If you have tried to release the poppet and you suspect that the valve may be broken, this is the procedure to replace the valve. The first step is to insert the valve wrench into the valve core. Next, reach underneath the RDC and grab the valve base, then twist the wrench in a counterclockwise direction, just like you were twisting the lid off a jar. In rare cases, you may need to use a screwdriver to get it to spin. This should only be done when trying to loosen the valve and never when tightening it. Hold on to the base underneath the RDC while you continue to loosen the top section. Once the top section has been released, there is nothing holding the base section in place. Try to keep the base section located close to the hole. Once the top section of the valve has been removed, you can see the threaded base section through the hole. Keep the base close to the hole while you prep the area around the hole. Wipe the area with a damp cloth to clean out all the mud and silt that may have built up over years of use. The trick is to make the area as soft and pliable as possible. You may see the concentric rings that have formed in the fabric where it has formed a very tight seal with the valve. The softer and more pliable the fabric, the better the rings can bite into it, and ultimately the better the seal will be. To help soften the fabric, we are going to warm it with a hairdryer. If the air gets too hot for your fingers, it is probably too hot for the fabric. At this point, add a small amount of liquid soap around the edge of the hole where the valve will be seated. This helps reduce the friction when you tighten the new valve into place. The soap should only be applied to the outside of the fabric, not the inside. Now you're ready to install the new valve. Line up the base on the inside. Thread the new valve core into place and finger tighten. As it goes in, it should be self-centering. Next, pull the valve cap off and insert the valve wrench. Reach behind and grab the base section and hand tighten the valve core. The liquid soap should help reduce the friction, and the warm fabric will create a very tight air seal. Do not use any cheaters to help tighten, as this may damage the valve. Here are the tools you will need to replace the fill valve or the pressure relief valve: a valve wrench, a new valve and valve cap assembly, a screwdriver to loosen the valve, but not for tightening, a heat source such as a hairdryer, a damp cloth, and a small amount of hand soap.